guys, welcome back to another The Shiver Review. Today I am at Climbers International in Nottingham to review this multi-million pound motor. And also I'm going to introduce you to Gary. He's going to show us an in-depth of the multi-million pound car.
Morning, how are you doing?
I'm good, thank you, Gary.
Good.
How are you?
Yeah, not too bad. I want you to have a look around this car and I'll show you some nice little treats on the car and see what you think.
Yes, please.
Do you like it?
Yes, I do. Really.
What do you think of the colour?
I love it, it looks absolutely stunning.
So, obviously, Pagani Huayra, yes. Roadster, this colour is quite unique. It's one off, so it's literally, there's not another one in the world in this colour combination. And the actual colour itself. So the colour is called Kurota copper. You see the copper lines, etc. So it took about 12 months for us to develop the paint, specifically because, as you know, Pagani Huayra is all carbon fibre.
Yes.
So they have to age the paint against the carbon fibre. So the carbon fibre has to be moulded slightly different opposed to a fully exposed carbon fibre. So the process involved is huge. So the funny thing about it is you would think to have a carbon exposed car will be expensive because you think that's going to be really expensive to do, to get the weave, to get the lacquer and everything, but it's actually more expensive to paint a Huayra. So because of the aging process on the carbon. So we decided to have this done in the two-tone. Again, this
Whose idea was it? It was Ian.
So Ian wanted something a little bit different. He wanted something that was quite unique. He wanted to go away from the norm. So, everyone goes with exposed carbon, the blacks, the greys, and some weird and wonderful colors. But he always had this thing with copper. Now, copper is a beautiful metal, it does, in the sun, it shines, it really, really does shine. So he thought, what about actually having a copper on a car? And that's how it all started. So, toing and froing from the factory, trying to explain to them what copper was, even though they knew what copper was, but trying to get the copper from a pipe or whatever, or a buckle, to same color match on the car. It was very difficult for them to do. So obviously the process, the matching, the toing and froings, I can show you my office. I've got, paint samples and carbon fiber. We probably had about 50 paint samples to actually try and match the copper. Now, when you look at the car now, it's probably, especially when you put it on video or take photos of it, it's very, very, it looks quite browny, salmon sort of pinky sort of colour. But when the car's in natural light outside, it's pure copper. So it's quite a unique colour that actually changes. So the difference is when you have a car in the showroom, you have showroom lights on it that really do pop and stuff like that. This does pop, but not as much as when it's outside. So when you see the car outside in its natural daylight, when the sun's shining, it's just like, wow, this is pretty special. So we had that done, but we also went for the fully painted. So literally the two-tone paint, and it's a fully painted Huayra Roadster. Now it's the only Huayra Roadster that's ever been fully painted. So again, Horatio, why are you trying to cover my masterpiece? But it's something that we want as a bespoke owner. So that's how we went around and we did it. So we had the subtle things like the exposed carbon lip down the side, the wing mirrors, you've got the Italian badge on the side, we've got on the gear on the back as well, we've got some of the carbon. So aesthetically, we wanted to make it a little bit different, a little bit unique, more so for Ian because it was his creation. So we did a lot to it to make it so special, yeah. So unique. And obviously Horatio and Pagani, yeah, helped us along the, yeah, journey to...
How much does the paint cost?
Yes. Believe it or not, £250,000.
Wow.
Just for the two-tone paint.
Real.
So, you know, you're talking, you know, you can either have a performante,
yes,
or a paint job.
Yes.
Personally, I'd rather have a performante, yes, but that's how unique a Pagani is. A Pagani is, you know, it's a very expensive, yes, piece of art, but it is so unique and so individual. You can have whatever you want, whenever you want, if you pay.
Yes.
So whatever, that's Enzo the guard dog, by the way.
Oh, okay.
So you can tell the, obviously, the car theme, yes, and the diamonds. But so yeah, so that was something that we wanted to, you know, kind of to do. And again, you know, when you go into the interior, the interior tan was something that matched with the copper.
Okay.
So having the tan done inside, the beige, the seat belts, have you seen this? Yeah, let me open it all for you. So if you come around, and I'll show you some of the gadgets. You look, the whole tub, which is quite unique, and not many people know about this.
Yeah.
So if you look at the carbon fiber on the tub, it looks, yeah, totally different. Now, the reason being is that is reinforced, so that is titanium carbon fiber.
Okay.
So he's the only person that's actually ever used titanium carbon fiber,
yes,
is Horatio.
Yeah.
So basically, so that's the monocoque, which, you know, obviously weight. So the car itself is, to be honest with you, it's actually it's almost stronger than the Kuten Jet, because he wanted something that's lighter, that's more nimble, and this is how he's kind of produced the kind of the carbon fiber,
yeah,
and the actual Roadster itself. But yeah, so if you look at the whole interior, so everything is bespoke, you know, from obviously the steering wheel, the tan inside, the leather floor mats, you know, all of that is just so unique. And, you know, from small little attention to details on the top, you go through the whole factory. It,
yeah,
it gets, it kind of, it's a bit OTT,
yes,
but it makes the car so bespoke to,
yes,
the individual.
Yeah.
And, you know, just small little things, like, you know, if you look, it's got the copper dials.
Yes, it has.
Which,
yeah,
you know, just small minor detail that, you know, Horatio did for us, just to make the car so,
yeah,
so special,
yeah,
and so,
yes,
unique.
Yes.
And obviously probably to justify,
yeah,
the price,
yeah,
as well. Because, you know, Paganis go up in value.
Yes, they do, yes.
You know, it's an appreciating asset. So,
yeah,
trying to get on the list to actually get a brand new Pagani.
Yeah, they cost about, they go into the millions, don't they?
Totally. You know, this thing set us back $3 million.
Wow.
With all the bespoke options and stuff like that. So, do you know, it's so unique. So, you know, you're talking $3 million, you know, you can have a Chiron.
Yes.
You know, you can have a LaFerrari plus another couple of other,
yes,
cars on top. This isn't faster than a Chiron, it's not, 0-60 is not quicker or anything like that. It,
yes,
is just a work of art.
Yes, it is.
The way they handle is unbelievable.
Yes.
They are so, such an agile car, but,
yes,
user friendly. So, you know, you jump in the LaFerrari, yeah, and it's fast, it looks fast,
yes,
it's,
yes,
very intimidating,
yes,
and you do have to have your wits about,
yes,
you. With this, it is such a well-balanced, you know, usable,
yeah,
hypercar.
Yeah.
And, you know, with the turbos that kick in,
yes,
you know, it's almost as far as, it's like driving a Bugatti,
yes,
but a more nimble Bugatti.
Yes.
Bugatti,
yes,
is very heavy,
yes,
whereas this is just so,
yes,
nimble, the turbos that kick,
yes,
in, the spools that, you know,
what
the turbo
got
spools.
You into the brand?
To be honest with you, I've always been into Pagani. It's something that, you know, Horatio, what he's done, is, I think this is fantastic, because he's actually gone against the norm. Yes. He's an actual proper engineer that's gone, actually, I'm going to make something that works, but also aesthetically beautiful. And he did that with a Zonda.
Yes.
And now, you know, a Zonda at the time, he struggled to sell them. You know, they were fetching £250,000.
Yeah.
Everyone thought, oh, it's a kit car. He's, you know, he's not going to be around. It's going to flop. You know, I can always remember reading something in the Autocar. You know, they put a Zonda against a 550 Maranello and against a 911 Turbo.
Yeah.
Now, if you look at in now's, you know, in today's world, what would you put a Zonda against? You know, a Zonda you'll put against a Bugatti, against a Carrera GT and stuff like that. So it's
a tuning thing as well.
You got it.
Yeah.
And that's the thing, and it's kind
of. I can remember the first episode of Top Gear. Jeremy Thompson put up a Zonda against the Merchant Honda.
I can remember that. Yes, exactly.
Yes.
You know, over the years, you know, Harry Metcalf, he had a Zonda and he did loads of miles in it and he used it as an everyday car.
Yes.
You know, and that was sold very cheaply, you know, in the 200s, years and years ago.
Yes.
That's probably worth now 4 or 5 million.
Yeah.
So that was kind of a bad investment deal on his part. But
yeah, because this is the first time I've seen a Pagani like this.
Hmm?
Normally I play them on my PlayStation games. That's the cars that I choose.
Do you know something? It's you know, everyone knows about Pagani, but no one knows about Pagani, if that makes any sense.
Yes.
So you'll never see one on the road.
No.
You know, the hype with the Zonda, everyone kind of went on the bandwagon because of the Zonda when it came out. It was a cool car, revolutionary, but didn't have the kudos of the Lambo, it didn't have the kudos of the Ferrari and stuff like that. However, the role has reversed.
Yes,
now
it's
the most iconic. You know, a person who drives a Zonda or owns a Zonda is a multimillionaire or billionaire.
Yes.
You know, the who's who of the car world will have one.
Now, with Pagani, you don't see that. Now, everybody's got a Lamborghini or Ferrari.
Yeah.
Yeah, no one, it's only a few amount of people who can afford one of these.
No, definitely. And the thing is, you know, if you are driving a, you know, a Bugatti or a LaFerrari and stuff like that, you want the attention.
Yes.
Whereas I think Pagani is the complete opposite.
Yes, they are.
So, you know, it's a proper enthusiast, a proper driver's car.
Yes.
And, you know, someone that's not really out there that wants to shout out, you know, look at me, I'm driving such and such. It's something that literally people, they want to collect, and attention to detail, like Ian we're talking about, you know, everything, you know, Horatio will go around every panel and sign every panel to make sure it's to his standard, perfect. You know, every bolt, every titanium bolt has got his logo, the Pagani logo on it. So to machine that, that costs thousands. And, you know, his attention, he wants it. He wants everything to be perfect. And, you know, that's the pursuit that he's done to make the engineering masterpiece.
Yes.
He's done it.
Yeah.
And, you know, the thing is, the Zonda is, you know, the Zonda is the iconic car for Pagani.
Yes.
I think this will soon follow.
Yes.
I really do.
Yes.
I'm quite lucky because the production has stopped now for Huayra. So the production is finished now. So all Huayra Roadsters have been done.
Yes.
So now they're producing the Huayra R.
Yes.
So that's coming out, hopefully going to be launched at Goodwood.
Yes.
And then there's a new C10 coming out.
Is there? Okay.
Yes. So the new C10 is amazing.
Okay.
So we've got one on order.
Okay.
Don't know if we'll go to this extreme of actually doing same color combination, but you never know.
Yeah.
So the C10
yes.
is, you know, everything's been quiet and hush hush and stuff like that, but I can tell you it's a mixture between a Zonda and a Huayra.
Yeah.
Mm. And they're making it in a manual. So actually having the same, you know, same engine, you know, the, obviously the 6 liter twin turbo in a manual, is gonna be phenomenal.
Yes.
Again, only 100 cars.
Yeah.
So when that comes out, that will be really special. But what will happen is, because the new model comes out, it will catapult the values of other cars. So it will catapult the value of this and the coupes. Okay. So if you look at a coupe now, you know, when they first came out, they were 750,000 euro.
Yes.
So they kind of struggled to sell them at the beginning. And then they slowly started to move, and then obviously the Roadster came and they went up a little bit more. Now they've shot up because Horatio is doing all the conversions. So, you know, you can add the Tempesta pack. He's now doing an option where you can have the same gearbox as the Roadster. You can have the tune up of the engine, because the coupe drives, it's chalk and cheese compared to the Roadster.
Yes, it is.
The Roadster is, you know, we've all heard of the BC. So this has actually got the BC engine, the running gear, the gearbox, etc. The only difference is the BC is stripped out. It's like a G, you know, it's like a GT3 RS. So this has got all the power, but also the comfort. And that's why the Roadster does, you know, does so well. But going back to what Horatio is doing, so everything that you could do with a Zonda, you know, with the 760 upgrade, and you know, Lewis Hamilton, he had the purple car,
the purple.
So he had the 760, so now they're doing those to the coupes on the Huayras, and they're going to be doing that onto the Roadsters. So if you wanted to do the upgrade, there goes another 1.5 million. So you have to be a, you know, a proper player to go into those again. So yeah, so it's kind of, it's an evolving market, and this is going up, and it's going up and up and up in value. And the thing is, if you don't need the money, why would you want to sell a creation? You know, and the thing is, you know, I've had many offers for this, but we won't sell it. And the thing is, you know, it's something that, you know, so many people have approached us and saying, listen, is there any way that we can just name a price and we'll buy it? But, you know, it's not something that we really, really keen on doing. Eventually, you know, if the C10 comes along and it is really, really special, you might consider selling it. But I love the brand, and, you know, I've had 4 Huayra Roadsters now. So, you know, and 3 of them been right-hand drive. Now, there's only 12 right-hand drive in the world, and only 5 UK cars, and I've had 3 of them. So I'm passionate, I love the brand, and you know, I'll carry on doing a lot more with the brand. The difficult thing is, you know, we don't have unlimited funds. And the values of these are going up and up and up and up and up. So, you know, something that costs 3 million, you know, new, it will probably be 5 million in a couple of years' time. So the thing is, and you won't be able to get one. You know, the only options are going for the second-hand cars. And they will again use the, like they did with the Zonda, use the chassis for the upgrade, so everyone will go, if you wanted something bespoke, you will go for the Tempesta for the Roadster, you'll go for the 760 upgrade, or whatever they're going to call it, to get them in. So, but no, it is, it's a pretty unique
car. What does the engine be?
Oh, yes. Let me show you that. Tell you what. And I'll also tell you, this one is also quite unique as far as exhaust is concerned as well. I've got a funny story about that as well. When I get this open, I'll show you. So what do you think of that? So if you look at everything, so you've got on the side, so you've got the 2 obviously luggage boxes, so that's the only luggage space that you'll have for the car. But look at it, everything is marked up, everything is labeled Pagani. The interior is just beautiful. So you've got the Mercedes-Benz AMG engine, 6 liter twin turbo. Now, there's one guy that builds those for Pagani. So there's only 100 engines, and that's why they limit the car to only 100. So Mercedes will only give them 100 engines, and that's why, per model. So there's a guy called Mike at AMG. He's, I don't know if you follow him on Instagram or Facebook or Twitter.
I've heard of him.
You should do. He is the most passionate engineer you'll come across, and that's why he works at Pagani. So he knows every engine. He can tell you the ins and outs, the statistics, you name it. And he's a great guy. And he interacts quite a bit. So, you know, the engine, everything is pretty cool. You also notice, not many people notice as well, you've got the trip computer. So it tells you how many miles the car's done and stuff like that. But you've also got, above the actual dials, it actually tells you how many hours or how many turnovers the car's had.
Wow.
So it's literally, you know, everyone looks at it and they think that's the trip computer, but it's not. So when you go in, you have a special. So it's literally how many times the engine's been turned over. So it's like an airplane or helicopter.
Yes.
You know, you've got flight hours and stuff like that. So it shows you how the actual engine's been run.
Yes.
But back to the little story. So when we went to the factory, we wanted to see what the car handled like. So Horatio said, I'll tell you what, I'm going to get one of my test drivers to take you out to one of the prototype Roadsters.
Yeah.
So I was there with my wife, Ian was there with his wife, and we took turns going out.
Okay.
And he came back to us and said, what do you think? So Ian perked up and said, it's beautiful, sounds lovely with the turbos, but for the value of the car, the exhaust note doesn't sound that good.
Yeah.
And Ian's own Enzos and Veyrons and various different things, and he's like, so I think Horatio kind of was like, oh, okay, fair enough, not a problem. So anyway, we carried on, and that was just a passing comment. So near the end of the production, it was a bit of a delay in COVID and various different other things. We got a message from Horatio to say, I've done something for you. It's something as just thank you for your business and stuff like that. I've redesigned the exhaust.
Yeah.
And it is now the loudest Huayra that's ever left the factory.
Okay, wow.
So going from someone saying that the exhaust note is, it's okay, but it's nothing special.
Yeah.
Because we all know cold startups and a Ferrari and stuff like that is really, really cool.
Yeah.
It was something that we wanted to do with the, you know, obviously with the Huayra. So with his exhaust, I mean, you can see the titanium exhaust anyway.
Yeah.
That comes as standard. But the noise and
it's just incredible.
Totally. I mean, you know Tom TGE.
Yeah.
He was blown away.
Yes,
because
I've seen that video. Yes.
Do you know, it's something that, you know, a lot of people, that's kind of the first reaction. It's such a beautiful car. It's nice when you start it up. Yeah, it sounds good, and you got the kind of turbo spools going when you're driving it.
Yeah.
But we'll start her up in a few minutes.
Yeah.
Let me know what you think.
Yes.
But I know everyone who's ever seen this car or heard it start up is kind of blown away.
Okay.
Literally. So again, everything in the back. Again, the wheels, you know, obviously coloured in bespoke Kurota copper.
Yes.
Again, that was something that was like, do we, don't we, can we?
Yes.
Which was a big question.
The tires are massive.
Huge, aren't they?
Yes.
And again, it's just, you know, all the handling of the car, because it's so light on the front end, heavy on the back end, but the aerodynamic flaps, which, you know, as you know, so going around corners and stuff like that, the flaps kind of, they work with the, just the flow of the air coming across the cars, just make it handle properly.
Yes.
I love it. You know, it's, I think it's just such a beautiful masterpiece, really. You know, a lot of the world at the moment is, you know, when you go to someone and say, can you do something, the answer to most things now is not too sure, let me see, because there's so many, you know, legislations and restrictions and various different things. Where Horatio comes into it, he's a can-do person. You want something?
Yes.
I'll do it.
Yeah. So, did you have to import this?
So we bought this directly from Pagani UK.
Okay.
So they helped us with the whole process of getting the order through, consulting with Horatio, going out to the factory, doing all the renders, doing all the, you know, the paint samples, the leather samples and stuff like that. So they did the whole shebang. Brilliant. Do you know something? It's just the way they look after you. It's irrelevant to the money. I mean, because everything is just monopoly money when you start talking about different things. You know, just small things like, you know, stitching the leather and the top dress. It's all, you know, it all costs money. But the process, I mean, if you look at the wall, you've got, you know, almost a massive, you know, picture where you designed the car. Horatio signed it personally for Yan. You know, just small things. So when the car went into production, they sent us two bolts, one for Yan, one for me. So, and a message from Horatio saying, these are the two bolts to start the build of your car. It's just that small little thing that cost almost nothing. Well, titanium bolts cost a lot of money, but just that small attention to detail to go wow. And then, you know, to follow on, you know, you sent us, I don't know if you saw it, with the render, hand painted picture of the car and the render. You know, it's just, it's those small tiny little touches that can actually, you know, make a buying experience more enjoyable. And then the icing on the cake is, we'll go around the other side, there's a model of the car. So they sent us a model of the car in the color, exact replica. And personally signed it. So to come in the showroom or Ian's office or whatever, but it is exactly the same as the car. And it obviously it's taken about 10 months to come. I won't tell you what the price is, but I kind of know what it is. But you know, it's kind of, you can buy yourself a VW Polo or Golf for the price of it. So, should we start her up? Okay, you ready? Have you seen the key?
No, I haven't.
So if you look at the key, it's machined, and you can see all the bolts and everything as well. So everything, attention to detail, it's all actual, you know, designed like the Roadster. So you get it in a lovely leather box that he signs it as well, so you get two keys of them. If you ever lose one of those keys, it's £10,000 to replace.
Oh my God.
Seriously. So, yeah, it's one of those that you definitely don't want to lose. But again, you know, it's, you know, compared to any other manufacturer, so you've got Lamborghini, you know, Bugatti, you know, Bugatti, their key looks like a VW Golf. So there's nothing on the market. I mean, the new Ferrari keys are quite cool, but this is just like, it's super cool. So I think that's quite a nice little quirky thing.
Wow, what a review that was. Before I end the video, I would like to say thank you to Gary Tolson, and also I'd like to say thank you to Kaiman's Internationals. And also follow me on Instagram, it's called TSRUK, and my YouTube channel is called The Shiver Review. Thank you everyone.